Señorita, cuidado con el coche, señorita.
I'm Peter Vives. I work as an actor, and I'm from Barcelona, Spain.
¿Está bien, señorita?
Sí, gracias. No lo he visto.
Tiene que ir con más cuidado. En esta ciudad, los taxistas se creen los dueños de la calle.
I started pretty young, actually. At 15, I got my first small role in Barcelona. I was, you know, just a kid at school, and I played basketball, so I got in this small, tiny role playing basketball in a movie. But funnily enough, the casting director was looking for kids that could speak in English. From there, I moved into acting school, and I got a role in The Cheetah Girls 2, which is a Disney Channel movie, and that was that. And I kept on studying, I got into physics, but at 22, that's when I got my breakthrough role in a Spanish series, and then I stopped studying, I finished my career, and I started acting full time.
Quiero que sepa que mi contacto ya está sobre aviso y cuenta con el traslado de su madre para cuando movilicen el siguiente operativo de evacuación desde Madrid.
So, María Dueñas, this writer, did her first book called El Tiempo Entre Costuras, The Time in Between. And it was a bestseller, not only in Spain, but then worldwide. And due to this, they decided to do the series. And I got a role in that. So after The Time in Between, when that was finished, I auditioned for the show who had already started, the first season had already been aired, which is Velvet. So I got a call from the producers saying they would very much like me to play this new character, which came out in the second season, who would make things difficult between Alberto and Ana, who are the, you know, the main characters of the show, and I would be like, you know, the bad guy who would make everything very, very hard for them.
Well, you look surprised.
Is it all right if we speak in Spanish? Otherwise, my friend might be up to join in.
Of course. Disculpe.
Well, I finished Velvet, and then I did another movie shot in Valencia, and I decided now I'm 30, it's the perfect time to come over to LA, and I'm here meeting people and having, you know, a great time. I've always wanted to work in English because everything I've done so far is in Spanish. I have played a British character, but it was shot in Spanish. You know, I miss the English and I need to work on that, so I thought LA would be the perfect place. You know, if you think of Bardem or Banderas, right, they all look pretty Latin, right? So it's easy, they'll get cast for Zorro or for specific parts, but, you know, I can't do this. I can't afford to have a Spanish accent in my English because I will never be cast, or it will be harder for me to get cast as a, you know, Latin character. Therefore, I need to really practice my American accent and my British accent, and I'll, you know, be able to also play a standard American guy or a standard English guy.
Espero que no tenga miedo a volar.
Always have, as I said, something else you'd love to do because you'll always be waiting for the phone to ring. So either you're very lucky or you're very determined and go to classes and you know, keep up with your manager, you know, update your showreel. But I do recommend you find something else that you love. You know, it will just make you feel more relaxed when you audition. And you'll see things from a different perspective as well.
Solo si me dices en qué estás metido.
Solo cuando me enteré.